Hello my dear students, how are you all? Welcome back to the grammar session. Today we will be learning a new chapter, that is vocabulary. Now, what do you mean by vocabulary? Vocabulary are nothing but words. We learn thousands of words in our day-to-day life and all over our life. But how to form those words, we will study today. In this chapter, we will be studying prefix, suffix, synonyms, similes, homonyms, antonyms and homophones. So let us start. So the very first topic we will study is prefix. Now what do you mean by a prefix? Now if we add a letter or a group of letters to any of the word, it becomes a new word and it also changes the meaning of that word. For example, prefix un and this. If we add these both prefix to any of the word before a word, we get a whole new word. Okay? For example, if the word is familiar. Now, if I add un before it, means if I add the prefix before it, the word becomes unfamiliar. So, the opposite of familiar we got just now, that is unfamiliar. Next is disbelief. Now, if I say believe, but if I add the prefix this before that, we will get a new word, disbelief. So, of course, here also we got the opposite. So, just by adding few letters or a group of letters to any of the word, we get a new word. Okay? For example, trust. If I add prefix dis to it, we get the opposite of trust, distrust. Same way goes with the word safe. If I add un prefix to it, we get a new word, unsafe. If I add the prefix un, we get a whole new word, unanswer. Same way goes with the word healthy. If I add the prefix un, we get a new word, unhealthy. After learning prefix, now we will study about suffix. Now, what do you mean by a suffix? Now, a letter or a group of letters added at the end of the word to make a new word. In prefix, we used to add before the word, and here we add at the end of the word to make a new word. For example, now here the suffix is less. If we add less to any of the word, we get a new word. For example, use. We have heard about this word many times. Now, if I add less to it, we will get a new word, that is useless. Useless means the things which we do not use. Next is the word color. But what if I add the word less to that word, we will get a new word, that is colors. So suffix is nothing but a group of letters which we add at the end of the word to get a new word. For example, harm. If I add the word less to it, we will get a whole new word, harmless. Thought. If I add the word less, we will get a whole new word, thought, thoughtless. Same way goes with seem, seamless. So, suffix is nothing but a group of letters which we add at the end of the word. Okay students, after learning prefix and suffix, now we will study about synonyms. What are synonyms? Let us look at the definition first. Synonym is a word which has the same or similar meaning as another word. If you have one word, but there are three or four words more which have the same or similar meanings, so that word is the synonym of another word. It also helps us to avoid repetition. Whenever you are writing something, an article or an essay or a paragraph, and you want to discuss something, you can use synonym. Means, if you have one word and if you want to express it in other language, you can use a synonym. For example, talk. Now we all know the meaning of talk. But if I say chat, do you think it has the same meaning? Yes. Talk and chat is the same meaning. It has the similar meaning. If I say speak, it also expresses the same meaning such as talk and chat. But if I say in my paragraph discuss, this also has the same meaning. So means if one word is similar to another meaning, it is called synonyms. Same way goes with nice. If I say kind, kind and nice are similar words. Same way goes with helpful. Helpful, kind and nice both have same also the word friendly. So if I want to say nice, I can say kind, you are helpful, you are friendly. Next is big. Now if I say huge, huge and big have the same meaning or the similar meaning. Same way with massive and large. So if I do not want to use the word big, I can use huge, massive and large. So let us look at more examples. If I say begin and start, begin and start have the same meaning. Rush, run, silent, quiet, scream, shout. So what are synonyms? Those are nothing word but the words which have the same meaning. After studying synonyms, now we will study about antonyms. So what is an antonym? Antonym is a word that means the opposite of another word. Antonym is nothing but the opposite word. For example, if I say the word always, this word has an opposite word. So what is the opposite of always? It's never. So never is an antonym of always. Next is like. The opposite of like is dislike. So the antonym for like is dislike. Happy, sad, different, similar. So antonym is nothing but the opposite word of the another word. So whenever we find the antonym of such words, it can be only the opposite words. Okay students, now we will study about homonyms. So what is a homonym? Let us read. Homonyms are words which have same sound and spelling but different meanings. So how is it possible that if you have the same word, same spelling, same sound, but the meaning is different? For example, the word notice. Notice means to pay attention. I just noticed a new garden which is built in my city. What did I do? I noticed. But if I say notice again, here the meaning of notice is information on a sheet of a paper. So here the spellings are the same but the meaning is different. Same way goes with the word save. If I say save, what comes in your mind first? If you are free from danger, you are safe. But if I use the word safe again, this safe means a box of valuables in which you keep all your jewelries or important documents. So here what is happening? The spelling is the same but the meaning is different. So that is called homonyms. Next is ring. If I say ring, what comes in your mind first? A piece of jewelry which you wear on a finger. But if I say this ring means when you reach home, give me a ring, means inform me. So again here the meaning is different but the spelling is the same. Next is cricket. So the first thing when it comes to our mind by looking at this word, of course you will say it is a game, a sport. But again if I say cricket, it is the name of an insect. It's a type of an insect, cricket. Next is trip. If I say trip, the first thing which comes to our mind is a journey, a picnic. So what will I say? I'm going on a trip next week. But if I say trip again, the meaning of this trip means to fall down. So here what is happening? The sound and spelling is the same but the meaning is different, and that is nothing but it is called homonyms. Okay students, now we will study about homophones. So what are homophones? Homophones are the words that sound the same but have different meaning and spellings. They only sound the same. So whenever we hear it same but the meaning and the spelling. Example, the word die. Die, die. What are you hearing? You are hearing the same sound. Die, die. But both have the different spellings and different meanings. For example, if I say die, your die means to expire. And your die means if we color something, if we paint something, means to die. So what are we doing here? The sound is same, but the meaning and the spelling is different. And that is called homophones. If I say flowers, flowers. Sound is the same, flowers, flowers, but these flowers are bunch of flowers and this is the flowers which we use in our kitchen. Next is one, one. Both have the same sound but both have the different meanings and spellings. One is the number, the numerical, and here one means to get success. Next is cereals, cereals. Both have the same sound but they have different meanings. This cereals we eat in our breakfast, and this series we watch in television. Next is no, no. Hair, hair. What are we doing? All the words have the same sound but different meanings and spellings, and these are nothing but homophones. And now we will study the last topic, that is similes. Now, what do you mean by a simile? Simile is an expression that describes something by comparing it with something else. In our day-to-day life, we compare each and everything. Unknowingly, but yes, we do. So, simile is nothing but comparing. For example, as light as a feather. Now, if you buy such a thing, a paper is very light. Now, if you want to compare a paper with something, what will I say? The paper is as light as a feather. What did I do? I compared two things. Next, as busy as a bee. Now, if you are visiting your friend's house, but she is always busy, what simile can you use over there? You will say, you are always busy as a bee. Why? Because bee is always busy collecting the honey. So, here we are doing comparison. Comparison is nothing but simile, which we do. Next is as cool as cucumber. If any person in a difficult situation stays calm, you can use the simile as cool as cucumber. Why? Because cucumber has the feature of always remaining the coolest. Next is as brave as a lion. If you go for an injection and if you are not scared at all, what simile I can use for you? I will say you are as brave as lion, because lion is the bravest. Yes, so here we finish our chapter vocabulary. So students, I hope you have understood. We'll meet in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Hello, my dear students. How are you all? Today we will be studying a new chapter, that is writing. Now in this lesson, we will be studying letter writing, message writing, notice writing, and so on. So the very first topic we will be studying is informal letters. Now there are two types of letters, formal letter and informal letter. Now, what is a letter? It is a written message when we send to someone. Now, the first we will study about informal letter. Informal letter means is a personal letter which we write to our friends, family and relatives. Now, how to write that letter we will be studying today. For example, this is your margin. Now, to the margin, we have to stick margin and we have to write all the steps. So the very first step in writing the informal letter is the address. Now it is very necessary for you to write your address, otherwise your friend or family or relative would not know who has written the letter. So the very first step is to write the address. Your address should be short and sweet, only in two or three lines. So I have written the address in two lines with a comma. The next step is to write the date. We have to mention the date in which, on which date we are writing this letter. So we are writing this letter on 14th April, 2021. After writing the date, we have to write the salutation. Now what do you mean by salutation? Now you have to write the name of your cousin or your friend or your relative of your or your family. So means you are informing that to whom you are writing the letter, and here you will write dear. Dear is a salutation for informal letter. If you are writing the formal letter, this salutation will change. So after writing this salutation, we will write the main message, that is called the body of the letter. Letter. After writing the body of the letter, you will leave a line and you will write complimentary close. Now, what do you mean by a complimentary close? Complimentary close in informal letter will be yours lovingly. In formal letter, it will change. You can write yours lovingly, yours affectionately. That is called complimentary close. And you will write your name over here. You will write your name over here. That is at the last, at the end of the letter. In this way, you have to write the informal letter. But always remember, all the steps should be at the left of the margin. That is, you have to stick to the margin and you have to write on the. After studying informal letter, now we will study formal letters. The steps for formal letter are slightly different from informal letter. Now, what do you mean by formal letter? Formal letter means official letters which we send to our officials, the officials, people of a company or a bank or a school. So now let us start how to write formal letter. The very first thing we change in formal letter is to write the name. First we have to write our name. If we are sending a letter to some official, so in formal letter we have to write our name. So here, who is the sender? Ritu Patel is the name of the sender. And after that, she has mentioned her address. That is 75 Vijayanagar, Hyderabad and the pin code. In this way, we write our address. Short and sweet. Next comes the date. On which date we are writing the formal letter. Next is sender's name and address. In formal letter, we have to mention the sender's name and the address. So to whom Ritu Patel is writing the letter? Ritu Patel is writing the letter to Mr. Thomas. And who is Mr. Thomas? He is the manager of LPG gas company. And of course, the address remains the same because the area of the gas company remains the same. Same way goes with city and the pin code. So in this way, we write the official address. Next, we write the subject. Now, what do you mean by subject? Your subject is written, complaint about gas leakage. We have to mention the subject in official letter so that the person who is receiving the letter can come to know the topic of the letter. Next, we as we write the salutation, respected sir. In informal letter, we used to write dear, but in formal letter, we write respected sir. Again, we do a comma and we write the body of the letter, the main letter. What is the complaint of Ritu Patel? That she has the problem of gas leakage. Next, after completing the body of the letter, what do we do? We give a complimentary close. So always in a formal letter, we write thank you and yours sincerely, yours faithfully. And after leaving the line, we write the name. Who has written the letter? Ritu Patel. And after that, we write sender's name and signature. So in this format, we write our formal letter. Okay, students, now we will study about how to write news. Now, what do you mean by news? The news which we read every day in our newspapers. So whenever you get a newspaper, what is the first thing you read? Yes, you read the headline. So here we will study about the format of how to write the news in a newspaper. Now, a news story is an article that tells us about the events which is going around in our city. It may include current political affairs, political issues, or any real life happenings. A news story should include, the very first thing is the headline, because without the headline we cannot come to know what is the topic about. So after reading the headline, we have our interest on reading the details of the story. So the very first thing should be the headline of the news. Next gives us a byline. What is a byline? A byline is the name of the writer of the news story. So here, who has written the story? Amar Sood is the name of the writer and he has written an article. And the date and the place where the event has happened. So here, the event has happened on date July 14. And what is the topic of our news? Mountain leopard spotted. So after that, after given a byline, now we have come to know the topic and the right name of the writer and the place where the event has happened. So after that, a lead paragraph that answers the question who, what, when, where and why of the event being reported. After that, we will write our body of the news. In that, we will include that where the mountain was spotted, in which place and what time. Now, the body which gives more details and facts about the story. Now, the body. The main paragraph of the news writing should give the entire detail of the entire event. In this way, we write our news writing. So now, students, we will learn how to write a notice. But before that, what is a notice? A notice is a printed or a handwritten document giving information about important matters. It is usually put up in a public place like a school and an organization. If we want to lodge a complaint or we want to tell a topic to a people, what do? We can write a notice and put up on a notice board for others to see. So here the notice is written by Ravi Sharma. Now Ravi Sharma is a student of 5th standard, Division A. What he has written? He has written that loss. So whenever you read a notice regarding the headline, lost, what do we feel? Yes, of course, there must be something which is lost. So we get a title. After the title, we write the date, on which date the notice has been written. After the date, we write the body of the notice. So what has Ravi Sharma written in the notice? He has written, I have lost my watch in the playground. It is a Titan watch with a silver strap. Whoever finds it, return it and will get a treat in the canteen. Please contact me if the watch is found. So here, Ravi Sharma has given the details that his watch is misplaced in the playground. If anyone finds it, kindly return. And he has given the details that it has a silver strap, etc. And last, what do we write? He has written the in the notice writing, we write the details of the writer. So here, who has written the notice? Ravi Sharma, which class? 5th Division A. So in this way, we write our notice writing. Now students, we will learn about writing message. Now when do we write a message? A written message is a piece of information that we write for somebody when we cannot speak to them ourselves. It is usually written in a box and is very brief. Whenever we are unable to communicate with others, what do we write? We write a written handwritten or a printed message. Now, how to write a message? Now, the very first thing we have to write is the date. On which date we have written the message? So, after the date, here comes the receiver. Now, this letter is written by a mother to her daughter, Anindya. So, who is the receiver? Anindya. So, her mother has written, Anindya, I am going out for some important work. Tell Papa to call the plumber as the kitchen tap is not working. I will be back by 8 o'clock. So after writing the body or the message, then we write the name of the writer. So who is the writer in this message? The mother. The mother has written the letter to her daughter giving some important message. This message should be brief, means short. So in this way we write message writing. Okay students, now we will study about story writing. Now, what do you mean by story writing? A story is a description of events in a proper sequence. So whenever we start writing a story, everything should be in sequence. It is written to entertain people. Take care of the following things while writing your story. So the very first thing is theme. You have to first decide the theme of your story. A story always has a theme. A beginning, a middle, and an end. Select your theme carefully and focus on it. First, you need to find out on which topic you need to write the story. How you will write the story, what should be the middle part and the end part of it. The next is characters. Now you decide who should be the characters of the story. A story, every story has a main character and some other characters. There can be animals, human beings, and things. Avoid too many characters for a confusion in a story. That will only create confusion. So the selected thing we do is we should choose our characters. And the next is setting. What do you mean by setting? Think of where your story can take place. You have to decide a place. Next, in a garden or at home or any imaginary place. Also decide whether your story is set in present tense, past tense or future tense. After you have decided all these things, then we start our story. Now here, first thing we write in our story is the title. First you have to decide the title of the writing the story according to these characteristics. After the end of the story, you always write a moral, that what we have learned from this story. In a story, there the very first thing comes the outline. The outline which we give you a small hint or a small type of a question from which you can make a story. That is an outline. In this way, we start writing a story. So students, now we will study about super sentences. We already know how to write a sentence, but what are super sentences? We will study. We form a super sentence by adding to or changing the details of a simple sentence. Now here we have a simple sentence called "The race was ran." This is a simple sentence, but if we want to convert the sentence into super sentence, what do? We just add the words. For example, here we have written "The swift race was ran." Here what did we do? We just added a word to make a super sentence. Again, if I want to add more words, I will say "The swift race was galloped." So here what am I doing? I am just going to add words to make a simple sentence into super sentence. Just keep adding words till you get a sentence with lots of information and details. In this way, by just adding the words, we can make a simple sentence into super sentence. Yes students, and the last topic which we are going to study about is exaggeration. Now what do you mean by exaggeration? Exaggeration means a tall tale is a story just told for fun. Whatever sentences we say or story we make just for fun comes under exaggeration. For example, Amit's dog is so small that he has to give him bath in a model cab. Now by reading the sentence or by hearing the sentence, do you think that it is possible? No, we don't believe. But what does Amit's friend has done? He has just exaggerated the thing over here. Same way goes with Rohan was so hungry that he ate all the dishes and bowls too. Now by hearing the sentence, do you think that this is possible? The situation is not possible, but here only exaggeration is done. So in this way, by adding all the impossible events, we can make a sentence into an exaggerated sentence. So I hope students you have understood this letter writing. We'll meet in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.